गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू हैव सॉल्व ऑल एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ चैप्टर 1. टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ नाउन फंक्शंस डिफरेंटली एट डिफरेंट पोजिशन इन अ सेंटेंस. नाउन फंक्शंस, नाउन एज सब्जेक्ट, नाउन एज डायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट, नाउन एज इनडायरेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट, नाउन एज ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द प्रीपोजिशन. अ नाउन मे बी प्लेस्ड एज द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ अ सेंटेंस, as the direct object, as indirect object, or as the object of the preposition. So first we'll read about noun as subject. Now first of all, what is a subject? The part of the sentence that tells who or what the sentence is about is called the subject. For example, the policeman appeared on the scene. Now here, what is the sentence about? A policeman. So a policeman is the first part of the sentence. The second part says something about a policeman, that is appeared on the scene. So the subject often says who or what performs the action that the verb refers to. Let's have a look on some examples that are given below. Navya ate ice cream. Now, who ate ice cream? Navya. So, Navya is the subject. Second one, the question is wrong. Now, what is wrong? The question. So, here in the sentence, the question is the subject. For this, you can remember that you have to put who or what before verb to find out the subject of a verb. You can see that in the first one, the verb is at. So, who is put before this verb? Who ate ice cream? Same in the second one. What is wrong? So, before verb, you have to put who or what to find out the subject. The subject of a sentence may be a one word noun, a compound subject, or a noun phrase with a head noun. Before this, you have learned that how to find the subject. Now here you are going to read that how the subject of a sentence may be a noun, it can be a compound subject or a noun phrase with a head noun. Let's see some examples. Snakes can slither up a tree. Now, ask the question with your verb to find the subject. Who can slither up a tree? What is the answer? Snakes. So here, our subject is snakes and it is a noun. Second example. Men and women cooked a meal together. Now, who cooked a meal together? Men and women. So here you can see that there are two nouns and they combined with the conjunction and. So we can say here that here the subject of a sentence is a compound subject. So compound subject is connected by and or with the conjunction or. See the third example. A skillful and intelligent carpenter makes good furniture. Now, who makes good furniture? A skillful and intelligent carpenter. Here you can see that it is not a single word there are not even the two nouns given, but here some group of words you can see. We can say that here it is a noun phrase. In this noun phrase, you can see a head noun, carpenter. A skillful and intelligent is qualifying the head noun carpenter. So here the subject is a skillful and intelligent carpenter. It is a noun phrase and carpenter is the head noun. Noun phrase is a group of words that acts as noun in a sentence. The head word in a noun phrase is noun. Let's go through some sentences which is given in your exercise A. The question is, underline the subject in these sentences. Now you know how to find out the subject. You have to ask the verb, or you can put who or what before verb to find the subject. You have to remember this, that you have to put who or what before verb. Five ducks waddled across the road. Now, who waddled across the road? The answer is five ducks. So, what is the subject? Five ducks. Second one, this oil has a magical effect on hair. Now, what has a magical effect on hair? What is the verb here? Has. Helping verb is has. The main verb here it is functioning. This oil has a magical effect on hair. So, you have to use what. So, the answer is this oil. Now, Kaur and Surbhi will travel to London next month. So, you have to use who before your verb. Who will travel to London next month? So the answer is Kaur and Surbhi. The fourth sentence, the science museum will be redesigned next year. Now, what will be redesigned next year? So what is the answer? The science museum. So what is the subject? The science museum. Now the fifth one, the engineers in the factory have designed a new car. Now, who have designed a new car? What is the subject? The engineers in the factory. Now, I think it's easy to find the subject in a sentence. Now, next topic is noun as direct object. Sometimes the subject may be the doer of the action conveyed by the verb in a sentence. In many cases, the action performed by the subject may affect or be received by another noun or pronoun following the verb. So, first of all, you should know that what is direct object. Then you can understand this topic. What is direct object? The noun or pronoun that receives or is affected by the action indicated by the verb in a sentence is called the direct object. Now, what is the keyword to find direct object? To find the subject, you have seen that you put who or what before verb. Now, to find direct object, you have to add whom or what after verb. So what will be the structure? That after the verb you have to put whom or what to find direct object. Let's have a look on some examples based on the above explanation. A carpenter makes furniture. Now, a carpenter makes what? What is the verb here in the sentence? Makes. So, you have to put what or whom after verb to find direct object. Listen carefully, because after that you have to learn how to find indirect object. So, if it will be clear, then only you will be able to find indirect object. So, once again see the example. A carpenter makes furniture. A carpenter makes what? So, what is the answer? Furniture. So, furniture is your direct object. Second example, the principal congratulated the football team on their victory. Now what is the verb here? Congratulated. So we'll put whom after this verb. The principal congratulated whom? What is the answer? The football team. Whom congratulated? The football team. So that direct object is the football team. In the same way, see the next one. I called a carpenter to make furniture. What is the verb here? Called. So put whom. I called whom? What is the answer? A carpenter. So our direct object is a carpenter. Let's solve some questions based on this explanation. This exercise is taken from your book. B question, underline the verb and circle the direct object in these sentences. First one, the chief guest announced a holiday in his speech. Now, what is the verb here? Announced. So it is already underlined. So ask the question to your verb to find the direct object. The chief guest announced what? A holiday. So what is the direct object? A holiday. Second one. Mohan takes his herd of sheep to the pasture every day. Now what is the verb here? Takes. So Mohan takes whom? His herd of sheep. So our direct object is his herd of sheep. I hope you understood functions of noun as subject and as direct object. In our next video, I will explain you noun as indirect object and noun as object of the preposition. You will also get the link to check answers of chapter number 1, but make sure that first of all solve all exercises and then check your answers. Thank you.